So the new topic or the next part of that is deep learning is convolution neural network. So we will start with convolution neural network. Okay, so the shorthand that we generally use is CNN, and wherever you will see CNN, the full form is convolution neural network. So convolution neural network is a class of deep learning network which is mostly used to do image recognition, image classification, object detection. So anything, any use case related to image or videos, we always go with CNN. Okay, so this is an example that Google uses photo search. So if you have seen Google Lens, that is nothing but a concept of CNN. So I will tell you a very good example of this. So when the Facebook was launched around in 2013, if I'm not wrong, 2013, 2012, initially when you used to post some photo, okay, whenever you used to post some photo, so it used to ask something, right? If you are posting a group of 10 people in that photo, then it should ask you to tag someone, right? If I'm not wrong, if you remember, down the line when around 2014,
Yes, sir.
yes, exactly, right? But
Now it's
nowadays,
automatically taken.
yeah. So basically, what you are doing for Facebook is you are creating a data set for Facebook. So initially, when the Facebook was launched, they ask you to tag you, then when they asked you guys to tag the people, actually they were collecting data from you. Okay, so basically they were collecting data set and they were making data set from your end. So they were just doing their work for free. Okay, so basically nowadays what happens is now it gives automation. Okay, do you want to tag so and so person? Now, do you notice that in Facebook? This is what exactly they have used behind the scene. So a convolution neural network. Okay, so the problem was that they don't have the data set, but they were smart enough to collect the data from our end without wasting money, without using anything. It was an easy step to collect the data set from our end, and from that day onwards they start getting the data, and now they have a very powerful system to detect people's. Okay, so yes, this is one of the example. Another example, do you know where Google is doing a very smart work taking data from you? Anyone? So one more thing is there where Google is doing that same thing, but you don't know that. Can you tell me what they are doing?
Google Photos, basically.
Photos.
Okay, not photos exactly. One. So have you seen the recapture thing where you have to click the photo where car is there?
Find out, I am not a robot.
Yeah, so in the recapture, there is no find out of traffic or find the car and stuff like that. That is nothing but they are doing labeling from your side. Okay, for you, it is like a security thing, but for Google, it's like data collection thing. Okay, so these are techniques that people or big company use to fool people and to collect the data. Okay, so this is how Google and Facebook have lots and lots of amount of data because of these tricks only. Okay, so this is one of the way, and there are many ways. Okay, there are many things that people are doing with us that we don't know. That's why we have a WhatsApp update, we have a security breach, and we have a security reasons. No, this is because of this reason only, and there are many other reasons. Okay, so if I talk about an image, what is an image?
Pixel, collection of pixels.
Made of.
Yes, so this is an image basically. So this is an image. So this is image that you see. This is an image that is there behind the scene, and this is what the image that computer sees. Okay, so computer can see things as we do, but for computer, image is nothing but a matrix. Okay, so this simple meaning is, suppose you see something that for you it's an image, but for a computer it's a matrix with some numbers inside that, and the number is nothing but a pixel values. Okay, and the pixel values is ranging from 0 to 55, where 255, 0 to 55 is a color range. And if we have three color range, we have RGB. This everyone knows, I guess, that R is for red, green is for G is for green, and B is for blue. And when we combine these two, and we get a color that we can see with our naked eyes. Yes. So this is an image. So what is in video? My question is, you have video, image. What is in video?
Collection of
Collection of
images,
images.
Exactly.
movement of.
Okay, so video. So video is nothing but a collection of images. So that's why when you hear that this video is 30 FPS or 40 FPS, this means that 40 images are captured at 1 second, or 40 second, 40 or 30 video, 30 images are captured at 1 second. This is mean by 30 FPS, 30 frames per second. Okay, so video is nothing but a collection of images. So basically you have to send each images at a time. That's it. So either it's a video or a image, everything is an image only behind the scene. It's just how fast it's moving from how fast it's moving. It fooled your eyes. So that's why it looks like a video. Simple. Now, this is the architecture of CNN. This is the architecture of CNN. So this part, you know, so which part, you know, the half part, you know, okay. This classification, that is flattened and fully connected layer and sort, this part, you know. Now this part you have to know. So now this looks tough. This picture is not making any sense, but as soon as I cover each and every topic, then I will come to this picture. Now this picture will make sense. Okay, that time this picture will make sense. So let's start by doing so. Okay, so there are a few steps that we have to do. Let's go to the step one by one. So this is a basic thing about the images. So the grayscale image is from 0 to 55, and the color images, we have RGB channel. So basically we have three channels and the value is between 0 to 55. So let's see the first step in convolution neural network. Okay, let's see the first step in convolution neural network, and this is called first level. Okay, so it's better to show you. Okay, someone sent the message. What's the message? Okay. So let me share my screen. Okay. So this is a whiteboard. Okay. Can anyone explain what do you mean by convolution? This is a mathematical term, or you have learned in engineering classes or in the 10th and 12th. Anyone knows what do you mean by convolutional? Okay, no worries. So suppose you have two functions. Okay, suppose you have two functions, function one and function two. Okay, so when you have two functions and you run this function two on function one, you get a new function called as function three, and that is called as convolutional. As simple as that. Okay, so I will tell you again. If you have a function two and you do some convolution with function, so this is function one and this is function two. If you do a function, if you convolute function two on function one, convolute in the sense when you put function, when you do the operation of function two on function one, you get a new function called as function three, and this is a new function. This is known as convolutional. Okay, now this is not making sense. This will make sense now. Suppose I have an image. Okay, in an image, if I say that the resolution of the image is 600 × 600, what that means?
Up to 600.
Anyone?
Width and height.
Six.
Basically, it's a matrix, right? So, width and height. So, means there are 600 pixels towards the width. There are 600 pixels towards the height also. This is what you mean by 600 × 600. A matrix concept. That's it. Okay. So, suppose I have an image. I have an image of 5 × 5, for example. Okay, this is for example. I have an image of 5 × 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and I have some value inside. This is the value can be 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Let's assume that this is an image. Okay, this is an image of 5 × 5. So what this image is, can anyone tell me what I will see when I convert this into color? Anyone? Okay, basically it will be a slanting line. Okay, it will be a slanting line. If you see carefully, this one is black and this is white. So if you see, it will be line. It will be a black line like this. Yes or no? So what convolution mean is, so there is a concept of filter. Okay, so we have to take one more matrix. Okay, we have to take one more matrix, that is matrix. This is a suppose one more matrix that I'm taking. The size of this matrix can be anything. Okay, the size of this matrix can be anything. Suppose I'm taking 2x2. So basically I am taking 2x2. And the value of this matrix can be anything. Okay, suppose I'm taking 1, 0, 1, or 0, 1. Suppose this is the value of the matrix. Now what we have to do is, suppose this is 2x2, this is 5x. This is the original image, and this is originally, this is called as function 1, and let it call as function 2. Okay, so what we have to do is, we have to convolute, or we have to put this matrix on this function. So how to do that? So the first step, what you have to do is, you have to put first matrix over here at the starting. So it will cover this first 4 pixels. Yes or no, everyone?
Yes.
Okay, now we have to do a calculation. What calculation? So 1 and 1 will overlap each other. Yes. 0 and 0 will overlap each other. 0 with 0 will overlap each other, and 1 and 1 will overlap each other. Right. So the two numbers which are overlapping, you have to multiply that. Okay. So what I mean is, 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into 1. Okay, so when you what is the value that you are getting? 2, right? So just write 2 here. Then once you have done this, you have to move this matrix one step towards the right. So 1 pixel towards the right. Sorry, 1 pixel towards the right. Now this black matrix will be here. Yes, everyone?
Yes.
Yeah, so can you tell me the value now for the second?
1 into 0.
0.
Then 0 into 0.
0 into 0, then?
Then 0 into 1.
0 into 1, then?
1 into 0.
1 into 0. What the value you are getting?
1.
1. Okay, so how 1? I don't know about 1.
How is 1 at 0? Right?
0.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, sorry, 0, 0.
Yeah, 0. Okay.
Fine.
Yeah. So now, once you have done this, so you have to write 0 here. Okay. Now, the next step is, again, we have to move a matrix towards the right. Now, the matrix will be here. Now, can you tell me the value?
Zero.
It will be 0. Okay. Then again, the matrix will move towards the right. So I will write 0 here again. Again the matrix towards the right. And again, this is 0. Also 0. Okay. 0. So 0 here. Yes. Now what will happen? This right side is exhausted. Now it will move once towards the, 1 pixel towards the down. So this will be here now. Okay, so I think this will be also 0.
Yes.
Yes.
So 0. Then again, you have to exhaust the right part first. So this will move once towards the right, once towards the right, once towards the right. And this is over, then again once towards the left. And this will go on until and unless all the cells are exhausted. Okay. So at the end, you will get a matrix like this. Right, so 1.
I think 2, 2, 2.
Basically 2, 2, 2 in a diagonal.
Diagonally.
Yeah. So this is the matrix you are getting, right? At the end.
Yes. Yeah.
So this is nothing but function 3. This is nothing but function 3.
It's similar to matrix multiplication. Right?
Matrix? No, not at all. Matrix.
No.
Element wise matrix multiplication, you can say. Yeah, not multi-multiplication, element-wise multi-multiplication. Okay, so yeah. So this is what you mean by convolution. So the first step is clear to everyone. Anyone has a doubt? How convolution works?
It's clear.
Okay, so I'm not skipping. This is what exactly behind mathematics behind the scene is. Okay, I'm not skipping anything. This is what convolution means. So you're getting 5x5 matrix. Then you're using a 2x2. What matrix you get at the end?
4x4.
Okay, so we get a matrix of 4x4. Now, so everyone, yes, go ahead.
The operation is always this only in convolution.
Yes, this only. There is no extra step that is there. This is actually what happens behind the scene in convolution. So you have an image pixel, you have some other that I will tell you what is that other small matrix that function two is, what we call it in convolution, but this is actually what it happens behind the scene. Okay, so no extra step, no omission extra step. This is exactly what it happens. So if you see my PPT also, so stop share and share the main screen. Yeah, this is what a convolution is. So this is a filter, this is an input, and this is the multiplication, and you get the value here. So this is exactly what I have told you. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, this is what convolution is. Okay, so let me share my screen again. Okay, not this screen, white screen. Okay. Now just do the rough work and tell me. Okay, just open a book and pen, paper, and stuff like this. If I have an input image of 6x6, that is a function one, and if I have a function two, that is of 2x2, what will the size of function three? I only want the size, okay? Like in the last example, I got 4x4, right? For this matrix, what will be the size?
5x5.
Okay, if this is 6x6 and this is 3x3. Now.
Here it will be 5x5.
Okay, so basically there is a formula for this. Okay, so what I mean to say, there is a formula for this. So initially, in the first example, if the 5 was given, right, and function 2 was 3, and the function 3, what you got is 4x4.
2x2, right?
F2
was
5x2.
Ah, 5x2. Okay, sorry, my bad. 5x2. Okay, so the simple formula is capital M minus small m divided by 1 plus 2 or plus 1, sorry, plus 1. This is a formula. This big M is for the function 1 or the image. This small m is function 2, and you will get function 3's size. Okay, so let's try to substitute here. What is the value of capital M?
6.
No. First example that I have taken. Yes. So 5. Small. The second matrix.
Two.
Divided by 1 plus 1. What do you get?
4.
So what is the matrix that you are getting? 4. Yes. Let's try to put this into 6 now. 6. 2, let's try to see. So this is function 1, this is function 2. Let's try to see the value of function 3. So the same value, capital M minus small m divided by 1 plus 1 equal to, let's see what the value we are getting for function 3. So capital M is 6 minus 2 plus 1 is how much? 4 plus 1 is 5. So this answer is 5. And the matrix that you will get for function 3 is what? 5x5. Okay, let's try to move this to 3 now. So you have to just substitute here now. So 6 minus 3 plus 1, and the answer is 4. Okay, so the final resultant matrix will be what? 4x4. So this is the formula to calculate the resultant matrix. So this is clear now to everyone, how to calculate the resultant matrix?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Now let me try to explain what that everything means. Okay. Instead of function 1, function 2, what actually it means. Now this is the big image that what I was showing to you. was nothing but the original image that you will train on. Okay, this is the original image. Okay, this is the image of size 5x5. Now, this small matrix, what you can see is, okay, so I am putting this, okay, this sign means that you are doing convolution. Multiplication with a round bracket. If I put a multiplication, that means that I'm doing matrix multiplication. If I'm putting multiplication and I'm circling that, that means I'm doing convolution. Okay, there's a difference. Now, this is called as filter. This is called as filter. Okay, and this filter can be a number of times. Okay, for example, so if this is a first filter, you're getting 4x4, right? A matrix of 4x4?
Yes.
If I use one more filter here, what the matrix will be of same size, 2x2, what will be again the size of this filter? The out resultant matrix?
4x4.
If I use one more, 4x4, right? So the hyperparameter tuning stuff here is the number of filters. Number of filters and the size of filters. Okay, so we have a filter. So how many filters will be there? It depends on you. How many? Depends on you. And size. Depends on you. Size in the sense, 2x2, it will be 3x3 or 5x5. But you have to make sure the filter size should be always smaller than the image size. So if the image size is 5x5, the filter choice that you have is 2x2, 3x3, and 4x4. You can't go to 5x5 or 6x3 and stuff like that. Okay, this is a constraint that you have to follow. This is clear to everyone? Okay. And one more thing. Suppose this is the image. This is an image of 5x5. You are doing a convolution of 2x2. That is 2x2. You get a resultant matrix of 4x4. Again, suppose I have told you that, okay, the number of filters I will be using is 2. So I will be using one more filter here. Convolution of this, again, I will get 4x4. Okay, so the resultant matrix will not be this is one matrix, two matrix. No, it will be the overall matrix. Okay, so the dimension of this 4x4 matrix will be 2. So what I mean to say is it will be 4x4 × 2. This means that this is the first matrix, and behind this will, the second matrix will be there. And suppose you are using 3 filter, the third matrix will be behind this. So basically, only one matrix you will get, but the depth will increase. This is clear to everyone what I mean to say. Again, I'm saying, suppose I am using these 2 filters, right? So I will get 2 matrix, right? But at the end, it will be not a 4 × 4, then again 4 × 4. No, it will be only 1 matrix, but all the other matrix will be patched up behind one behind each other. So it will be 4x4 × 2. This means that 4x4, and there will be 2 matrix of that. So this is X, Y, and width. So now if I'm using 3 matrix, then what will be the size of the matrix?
4 × 4 × 3.
So this will be stacked one other behind. Okay, this will be a single matrix, but stacked one behind.
Filter size should be same, right? 2 × 2. It cannot be 2 × 2 or 3 × 3.
No. The filter size here should be same. So the filter size, if you are deciding that I want to put a filter size of 2x2, so all the filter size will be 2x2. There is no option that one filter will 2x2, one filter will be of 3x3. No. If you're deciding one filter size, all filters will be of the same size. Your voice was not clear. Can you repeat?
The contents will be different for every filter.
Siddhi, I think you have a network issue or voice issue. Please, can you rectify that? Because I'm not able to hear that. Can anyone tell me what she's trying to say?
I think she's talking about the content of those matrix.
Ah, okay, content of the small matrix.
Content of the different filters should be different.
So she's asking what will be the this value inside this matrix, yes?
She's asking that
it will
be different.
Yeah, so basically this is nothing but weights. In short, this is nothing but, so all the things inside this is nothing but the weights. So this is the weights, the same thing what you have learned, how to initialize the weights, the same thing the weight will be initialized here, also random weights. So value inside this will be random. Okay, the value of this will be not random. This is the image pixel, the pixel value. But the value inside this will be random values. That is weights that you have learned in the if you previous classes. The same technique is used here also. HE normal, Xavier, Gorod, everything is same. But that the value here inside is not fixed. It's a random value that we have to decide. Okay.
And for each filter, the values will be random. Like it won't be equal between the filters.
No. This filter, the value will be different. This filter, well, the random value. This will be the random value. And inside this, each filter will be random value. So basically, all values will be the random value. It's clear, Anjani?
Yes.
Okay. So any doubts still here? Anyone wants to ask something? Any doubts still here? They can ask. Okay, this is only the first step. Yes.
And the 4x4x2 that you have written, the resultant. Mm-hmm. So 4x4 is our function 3 rows and columns, like dimensions. And 2 is the weight, right?
2 is the weight, yes. So how many filters you are using, that will be the width of the resultant matrix. So basically, if you are using 6 filters, then the width will be 4x4 × 6. So all the filters will be stacked behind each other. So basically, if you stack it, it is changing dimension, right? So with dimension is changing, so it is 4x4 × 3.
Okay.
This the pixel size, right? 5x5. It can be 5x10 also, right?
This pixel 5x5 is the image size. If you're giving an image size of 1000 × 1000, that will be 1000 × 1000. This is depend on you. What kind of data set you are giving?
Is the length and the width always the same?
No, not at all. It can be 5 × 10. It can be 20. So basically, it should be a square matrix. Okay, basically, if you want a good result, the image size should be a square matrix. So basically, the row and the width should be same for getting a better result. Okay, so it can be of 100 × 200 also, but it's better if it's 100 × 100. Getting my point?
So if it's a rectangular matrix, we cannot calculate the size of the function 3, right?
Yes. Then we can. That is, so see, it, as I told you, it is already recommended to use the square matrix, because then only the everything function and everything will work. So yes. So the answer is the size of the width and row and column should be the same. Rectangle you can put, but you will not get the correct value. Some or the other, you will get an issue. Sure. Getting my point?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
So in such a case, you have to modify the picture, is it? Image.
Sorry? Yes. So suppose you are getting a very high image. So with the help of some function, that is, we have CV2, we have lots of function. With the help of that, we have to resize the image. So I will teach you each and everything how to resize. Suppose your input image that your model takes is 44 × 44, but you are giving the image size of 500 × 500. So how to resize that image to 44 × 44? That I will teach you. Okay.
So same is true for filter size as well. It has to be 2x2 or the width. Row and the height has to be the same.
Yes, everything should be the square matrix. In this convolution, everything should be the square matrix. You can't change the dimension to 2 × 3 or 3 × 2. Everything is a square matrix. Square matrix in the sense the rows and the columns should be the same.
Okay.
So you can't give 2x3 or 3x3. It is always 2x2, 3x3, 4x4, 5x5, 10x10, 11x11, like that.
What the...
Yes, sir. No, nothing. I have nothing to say.
I was asking that what does the width do to the image?
What does the width?
Width, the final resultant three.
Yes.
What does width do to the resultant image?
Yeah, yes, I will tell you. There are 5 steps you have to follow. I'm on step 1 only.
Okay.
So let's So just making sure that everyone understood first step. There are more steps after that. Then we have to So the first step is clear to everyone. Anyone, any more doubts you want to ask?
We're good.
Clear.
Okay. Now in step 1, there is one more concept, and the concept is called a stride. STRIDE, stride. The stride is that how many pixels you want to move towards right and left. So if you remember, my filter was moving one step towards the right every time, and down also.
Right.
This is called as, that is called a stride 1. If I do stride equal to 2, what that means?
It will move 2 steps.
2 pixels.
Yeah, so basically if this is 5 cross 5. And this is 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So basically, initially when the stride was 1, my matrix was moving something like this. So this is a first. Then the next pixel was here. And then the next pixel, then the next filter was here, and so on. But in this, in stride equal to 2, my matrix, that a convolution matrix or the filter, will move 2 steps now. So what I'm going to say is, suppose this is a first, then it will not skip the 1 pixel, it will skip the 2 pixel. Now next matrix will be here. Okay, then the next matrix will be here. Then the next matrix will skip down also 2 parts. So next matrix will be here. Then next will be here. And next will be here, and so on. Okay, so this is the meaning of stride. So this is also a hyperparameter tuning thing. Okay, the stride depends on you whether you want to go with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever stride you want to go, you can go with the stride. So the stride concept is clear now?
Afshan, earlier you took the stride as 1, here you took as a 2, right?
Yeah, this was 2. This what I was showing was 2. Stride equal to 2.
But earlier what you did, 1 step forward and down. So
that is stride
1.
That is stride 1, yes. So stride is nothing but how many steps or how many pixels you are skipping towards the right and towards the down.
Thank you.
Yeah. So
at the third stride, it is moving, like the matrix is getting completed, and so what happens then?
Oh, like, yeah, here you're saying, right?
Here and downward.
Yeah. So there is a con. Yeah, so I was coming to that. So suppose now what is happening is this stride is not filling the data, right? So basically you have the data here, but not here. So there is a concept of padding also now.
Okay,
the concept of padding is that if the padding is 1, this means that at every row and column, 1 padding will be added. Okay, so example, 1 row on the top, 1 row, 1 cell on the down, 1. Okay, so I will just clear this. I will draw one more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so the padding means that. Undo. Yeah. So the padding, what is the meaning of padding is, when I say padding equal to 1, so this means that 1 cell will be inserted here, 1 cell will be inserted here, 1 cell will be inserted here, and 1 cell will be inserted here. So suppose this is a 5 cross 5 matrix. Now what is the new matrix that I'm getting? So
7,
right? Why? No, not 6. Remember that this is adding on top also and bottom also. So 2 at M, so 7. 7 cross 7. So now this is what we call by padding now. So the padding and a stride concept is clear?
And what will be the numbers inside padding?
It will be, it is called a zero padding. So basically, all the values will be zero inside this.
Okay.
By default,
and
yes.
Afsan, I have one question more. Like I asked you, but due to microphone issue, I was not able to convey it. That if we are using filter here, right? But yes. What is the purpose of that filter? Why we are doing convolution to the image?
Yes.
I will multiple filters also. One is fine.
Yes. Got it. I will tell you.
Yep.
So once my first step is clear, I make the mathematical concept clear, I will tell you the logic behind that, okay? So the padding and the stride concept is clear to everyone?
Yes.
Okay, so why we use padding? The question is why we use padding? We use padding, suppose this is 5x5. If we use 2x2, what is the output resultant matrix size you will get?
4x4.
What if I want to get the same size as the image size? What I mean to say is I want to do 5x5, I want to do 2x2, but I want here 5x5 only. I want the same matrix as the image size matrix. So what you have to do is you have to do something called as padding here. So padding is for that. Okay. So now if I do the padding, so what this will do, if I do padding of 1, this matrix turns to 7x7. Yes.
Yes.
This matrix turns to 7x7. Now 2x2. Now 7 - 2 is what?
5
plus 1 is what? 6x6. Right? So What happens now is the formula is changed now. Okay. Now this will not be a formula now. Whenever you are adding a padding, the formula changes. Now the formula is m into 2p minus small m divided by 1 plus 1. Now, what is m here? 5x5. Yes?
Yes.
So this is plus. Sorry, my bad. This is plus. Padding is 2. So plus 2 is how much? 5. My bad. So this is 5. This the padding is of 1. So basically 7. Yes? Minus 2 plus 1. Let me check. This is a formula mistake I'm doing. So basically, if this padding is 7x7, if I do 2x2, what a size I will get? Can anyone tell me by normal convolution?
6x6,
right? Okay, 6x6 is the correct thing. Okay, so if I told you that 5x5 is here and you want to do 2x2. You get
four cross four.
Okay, so this is correct. Okay, so what if I want to increase the size of the matrix? So you have to do the padding here, 7x7 into 2x2, and this will come to 6x6, right? If I'm not wrong, yeah, the calculation is correct. Okay,
so you want same size of target and image.
Yeah, so basically the concept of padding is to get the same size as the target and the image. So basically you have to work with the formula for that. So there are two main concepts of using padding. Okay, the first main concept is, you have seen that when I do the stride of two, what problem is happening? That at the end, the matrix is exhausted, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
So to fill that matrix, we have to use 0 and 0 by default. So that is the concept of padding. And one more concept is, if you want to take the image size and the matrix size same, then you use padding. So for what I mean to say, suppose this is the image size and the resultant size you want as same as the image size, you use padding. For that, you have to use a calculation of this. M plus 2p minus small m divided by 1 plus 1. Okay, this is a formula you have to use to get the same as the resultant matrix. Okay, so this is the formula. So whenever you are using and one more thing. This is one is because the stride is 1. Okay, the stride is 1. Now when the stride is 2, this becomes 2. So this is, if I restructure the formula, this is the overall formula. Okay, the overall formula is m plus 2p minus small m divided by s plus 1 is the resultant matrix, is the resultant matrix size. So m is the matrix size that you are giving as the image size. This is the padding that you are giving. This is the small matrix size that you are giving, and this is the stride you are giving. Okay, so according to what you are giving, you calculate the resultant matrix. So this is clear to everyone?
Yes.
So this is the formula for that. Okay, this is the formula for that. Now, so, yes, go ahead.
So when we do padding, it is always done like on four sides. We cannot control like which side we want to do the padding.
No. If you are doing a padding, it will done on all the four sides that you can't control.
Okay.
On the fourth, because what will happen? I told you that I want a square matrix, right? So that's why the padding should be done on all the four sides.
No feed-in.
Yeah. Okay. Anyone was saying something?
Value.
One by one. So you want you wanted to ask what is the value of P will be?
Yes.
So the value of P will be zero. So basically it is called as zero padding. So all the values inside the padding will be zero by default. So you can't put any value, so value will be zero only.
So here in this case, it will be like 5 plus 2 into 0 minus 2, right? Divide by, we are taking stride 2.
This is the padding is not, the. This is not a value. This is the padding value. Okay, for example, this M is the 5 into 5, right?
Yes.
What is the padding that you are using? 1. 1 means all the rows will be inside 1 towards the left, right, and bottom and top.
Yep.
So this is 2 into 1. So what is the total matrix I have? 5 plus 2. That is 7, right?
Okay, we are just adding one row padding. So we are using 1 here.
Exactly, yeah. Okay, so okay, suppose you use 2 row padding, so it will be 2 here.
Okay, got it now.
Yeah.
Means the values inside the this matrix that we add is 0, right?
Yeah. So basically, if you are doing a padding, the value will be inside will be 0. But what is this? This is padding of 1. The value inside that padding will be 0, but this is padding of 1. This means you are adding each row and column 1. That is meaning of padding 1. So in the formula, if you see 2 into P, that is how much padding you are adding, not the value of padding. Okay. So, but the value inside the padding will be 0, 0, 0 everywhere. You can change this. So here also 0, here also 0, here also 0, and here also 0. It's clear now?
Yeah.
Formula wise, if we try to calculate, should we get the same target and source size? Like 5 into 5, I want to get a destination image as 5 into 5. So how can I get that one using padding?
So your question is, suppose this is 5 cross 5 and you are using 2 cross 2. The resultant matrix is 4 cross, right?
Cross 5, again.
4 cross 4, right? So what you are telling...
5 cross 5. The destination should be again 5 cross 5.
The destination again should be 5 cross 5, you are saying. Okay. Yeah. So what we have to do is, so basically you have to convert this with the help of padding. So you have to add the padding for that. I think it will not happen. Okay. So basically what you have to do is, let's see. Let's try to find the formula. So 5 minus 2 divided by 1 stride plus 1 is how much? This is 3, 4 cross 4. Yes. If I use padding, now it is 7 minus 2 upon 1 plus 1 is 6 cross 6. Okay, now you have to play with the filter size here now. So let's try to play with the filter. Now let's put to 3 cross 3. So 5 into 3 is what? Okay, so yeah, so I basically have to do the calculation basically. So let me check about the calculation now. So 5 minus 3 upon 2 plus 1 is what? 3 cross 3, yes. And 7 into 7 minus 3 plus 1 is 7 minus 3. So basically, after the calculation, I am just talking about the calculation. But if you want to get the same matrix size, you have to use padding. So just say some calculation machine that I'm doing. Okay. So I will rectify that and will tell you. So basically, let me check. Okay. Let me check now only. Okay. Let's see in my PPT if I have given that formula. No, in the PPT I have not given. So I will tell you how to. So basically, you have to follow the calculation, and there is some calculation mistake I am doing here. So I will rectify that. Okay. Yeah. So don't worry about it. I will rectify some mistake I am doing here, which I am not able to identify. But I will rectify that by tomorrow, or if I get the formula right now, I will just rectify that.
Okay,
Afsar. Okay, so let me check first. So CNN. So two. Okay. Okay, I will tell you the formula tomorrow. Okay, I think something I'm missing. I'm not just remembering that. I will tell you tomorrow. In the tomorrow's class, or if I in the group only, I will mention. Okay, so how to do that thing. So I will do the calculation. I will take the screenshot and I will send to you. Is that fine?
Yes. Afsan, one more thing. When we are doing padding, we are doing padding for two reasons. So in one of the reason is when the matrix is getting exhausted. So yes, at yes. that time, we have to pad only where it is getting exhausted or on all the four sides.
No. There is no option of padding on only one side. If you're doing a padding, all the four padding will be done. Okay, so by default what will happen is now it will be 7x7 and your matrix will again start from start. So what I mean to say is, suppose this is 2x2. Okay, so if you're doing a padding, okay, so I will again make 2 5x5. Okay, so suppose you are doing a padding, so one row will be added here. Yes. Here also, and here also. Correct, everyone?
Yes.
So basically, you have to start from this now. Your matrix, your filter will start from here, then skip two, it will be here, and skip two, it will be here. So it will go something like this. Now it's clear or not? So basically, it will not start from here, not 5. Now the original size of the image is turned from 5x5 to 7x7. So again, it will start from starting. Again, it will start from the starting. This is what a padding is. This is why we use the padding. Now it's clear?
But then again, the last one is incomplete.
Yeah, so basically, that's what I'm saying, you know, that the filter size you have to take care of. So this 2 is not fitting, then you have to go with 3x3. Now it will fit. So this is a hyperparameter tuning thing that you have to work on.
Okay.
Getting my point? So that's why I've told you that this is a hyperparameter tuning. If 2x2 is not helping there, then you have to go with 3x3. If this is not helping there, you have to go with 4x4. Getting my point now?
There will be some method like we have in machine learning normal, like to choose the what is the best and which is fitting correctly over there.
No, we don't have any method. We have to just do hyperparameter tuning on
okay,
on
our it's own. Just try and catch, right?
It's a try and catch. Yeah, that's why deep learning is tough to build a model. Once a model is built, then yes, everything is fine, but to build a model, you have to think a lot.
Okay.
What will be the filter size? What will be the filter values inside that? How many filters you have to decide? And this is only first step, remember.
Okay.
And you have five steps. So many more things you have to do, take care of.
Okay.
So this is not as simple as you're thinking. It is very complex. Okay. The understanding will be easy, but to build a model, you have to decide, okay, 3x3 will work best, or 4x4 will work best, and so on. Any more point?
Yep.
Yeah. So welcome to deep learning. Yeah. So this is what we have to take care of. Okay.
So, Afsan, we talked about we were trying to get the same matrix like as an output.
Yes.
If you were taking 5x5 and you wanted 5x5. So yes. In that case, with like the second decimal matrix, right? Using which we could get the result.
Yes.
So if suppose we change the second matrix to 3x3,
mm-hmm.
and keep the padding as one only, mm-hmm. and side as one only, then we could get like 5x5 based on the formula.
Yeah, so the formula is correct. The formula is correct, but just the putting of the formula and the putting. So suppose something I'm missing that I'm not able to do. So you're saying that change the filter size. I agree with that.
Yeah, I changed the filter size to 3 and I got the resultant 5x5.
Yes. You will get that way. But I will just explain in a better way tomorrow. Okay. Because something I'm missing, which I'm not remembering right now. Okay. Some step or some formula I'm doing some small mistake, which I'm not just able to think right now, but I will come to that tomorrow. Don't worry about that. I will rectify each and everything.
Okay.
Okay, because the formula is not easy to remember, no? So that is the problem. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So yes, I will tell you. Okay. Now the question was why we are doing this. Someone asked me the question that why we are using filter. What is the purpose of using filter? Why only one filter, two filter, three filter? The purpose of using two filter is this. So basically, what you are doing is, suppose you have an image here. You have an image here, and the purpose of using the filter is to extract the features. Okay, so what I mean to say is, suppose this is X. This is X. Okay, X is literally the X symbol I'm talking about. Okay, the X symbol. Now, our job is to extract the feature of X. So what is the feature of X? Two lines with cross, right? 1, 2. This is X. Yes or no?
Yes.
So the purpose of this filter is to extract the same thing. The purpose of the filter to extract the feature. So one of the filter that I am using will extract only this line, and other filter will extract this line. At the end, what happens? This gets tagged, right? One behind the other. The output of this, what happens if you do this? Okay, so basically, okay, let me do. So if I have, this is the original number that I have X. Okay, and I have a filter that has some values, and at the end it gives me the features, and the feature is one feature is like this and one feature is like this. If I stack this one behind another, what I get? The original limit was
X,
right? So this is the meaning of filter. So basically the filter will extract the features, and at the end it will try to give me some of the feature of that cat. Okay, so what is the feature of cat that you distinguish with? So if I give you dog and cat, so what you look in dog and what you look in cat to distinguish between cat and dog?
Height,
correct. Height, then cat has sharp ears, and yes, cat is small, yeah. The tail and everything, right? The same thing that does filter. So filters try to extract the feature of the cat. Like it will identify, okay, cat has a sharp ears and dog has a round ears and stuff like this. Okay, so this is a filter of the job is to get the unique feature which is not common in cat or dog. Getting my point now? This is why we use filter. And one more point is, this is a black box. Can anyone explain what do you mean by black box?
Nothing is visible, probably. What happens?
Exactly. So suppose this is an example I'm giving you, right? So you don't know that what feature my convolution is extracting to identify whether it's a cat or dog. You don't know that. So for example, I'm saying the sharp ears and round ears. For a convolution neural network, it will be some other thing. That other thing you can see actually. You can see and print the matrix, but that will be something else which you will not understand. But CNN will understand, okay, for cat, this is a unique feature, and for dog, this is a unique feature. So this is getting extracted, this means this is dog, and this is getting extracted, this means this is cat. So that what is mean by black box. So what is happening inside, that is only known to convolutional network, what is doing behind the scene. If you try to see the matrix, you will see some random colors, which you don't understand, but convolution will understand, okay, this is a cat and this is a dog. So it's clear to everyone now what I mean to say by black box.
Yes.
So the purpose of the filter is to extract the features, but what feature it will extract, it depends on the filter or the convolution. Okay, so if you try to extract the matrix, it will be a useless thing, but for convolution is a useful thing. So that's why this convolution network is called as a black box. So you can't just see and visualize, okay, for cat this is a feature, for dog this is a feature, and this is how it is learning. No, this is a full black box, so you can't figure this out, that what's happening behind the scene. That's clear?
Yep.
Okay, great. The basic point is that how calculation happens. And the calculation is clear to everyone? The step one calculation is clear to everyone?
Yes.
Okay, so this is a step one. Now let's go to step two. Let's move to step two. Now what happens in step two is, okay, so wait, let me... Okay, sorry. Yeah. So step one is convolution. So this is convolution. Step two is you have to use the activation function. And this everyone knows. Either you have to use ReLU, or you have to use, what is the other function? Sigmoid. So this is up to you what you want to use. Okay. So how here the ReLU and the sigmoid is used? Very simple. So at the end of the step one, what you get? Resultant matrix, right? 4x4, if I'm not wrong. 4x4, and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. So you get some values also inside this. Of course, you are adding. So suppose I'm getting 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 2, 0. So what you have to do is you have to apply the activation function. So if I apply ReLU here, so ReLU will be applied to each pixel value. So what is the ReLU of 2?
2.
Value of 2. So basically you will get the same matrix, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So every time my weights will not be in positive. You know that, right? There is a range, right? So the weights can be negative also, yes or no?
Yes.
If you remember the Xavier and the Gorot, if you try to remember the formula, the weights can be negative also. There I have taken positive, I'm getting all the positive values. Now, for example, if this is -1, this is -10, and this is -20, so what will happen to this -10, -1, -20?
Zero.
It will become zero. Okay, this is basically to normalize the data so that our convolution network will perform faster and it will extract more features like this. So this is... either you have to use ReLU or sigmoid. So the same function, what you have learned, the concept is same, just each pixel value will be ReLU applied. That's it. So each pixel value will be ReLU or sigmoid. So this is a step two. So the both steps are clear to everyone. Any doubts?
No.
Clear.
This is called as step two is simple, right? Step two is simple. Now we have something called as step three. So step one is done. step one is done. Let's move to step two. That is also done, that we have to use the activation function. Now, step three is called as pooling. Step three is called as pooling. So basically, pooling is reducing the size of the matrix. Okay, so for example, this is 4x4. So the basic fundamental of pooling is to reduce the size of the matrix. So the pooling layer can be 2x2, 3x3, 4x4, anything of your choice. So the same concept what you have done in convolution. So you have to put the pooling layer. But note this pooling matrix, the value will not be anything. Okay, in the convolution, the filter value was there, that is the weight. In pooling, it will just come on this. Okay, 2 0 0 0 0 2 0 0 0 0 2 0 0 0 2 0. What convolution, what max pooling is, suppose I'm putting the filter here. So the job of this pooling is to get the maximum out of these 4 pixels. What is the maximum value out of these 4 pixels?
2.
Then my pooling will move towards right. Okay, towards the right, 1 pixel towards the right. What is the maximum value here? In this pixel?
2.
Then it will here now it will move here. What is the maximum value?
Zero.
And this will come down also like this. And like, so the maximum value is
two. Again.
Then the down part. It will be
zero, two.
So this is a new matrix, but the dimension is reduced now. The dimension was 4x4. Now the dimension is 3x3. This is the job of pooling. Okay.
We can use the getter tried here also, like we are.
Yes. See, here you can't use padding, but you can use stride. So stride can be 1, 2, 3, 4 of your choice. Suppose you want to get more smaller matrix, you can use a stride of 2 also. So let's use the stride of 2 now, just for a demonstration purpose. Okay. So stride will be, padding is only for the starting part, that for the image. Okay. Here it will not work padding. In the middle, you can't use padding. It's not allowed. So 1, 2, 3. Now, if I'm using a pooling of 2x2 and the stride is of 2, so the first value will be here. Yes, everyone. Second value will be here. Second matrix, the position will be here. Then it will be here. And then it will be here. So, what is the size of the matrix?
2x2.
Okay, so basically, max, this is called as max pooling. You are extracting the maximum of the 4 pixels. Now there is called as mean pooling also. Mean pooling is extracting what?
Minimum value,
exactly. And we have something called as average pooling. What is that?
Mean, extracting the average.
Yeah, so mean of this 4 will be the pixel value. Mean of this 4 will be 1 pixel value. Mean of this will be 1 pixel value, and mean of this is 1 pixel value. So they tell here it's clear. This is step 3.
This is step 3.
Again, see, in step 2, you have to decide between ReLU and sigmoid. That is one hyperparameter tuning. In step 3, you have to decide between the size. Right? That how many size you want to use. Yes or no? What is the max pooling size you have to use? That is one more thing. In this, you have to choose the stride also, what you have to choose. So basically, you have to take care of lots and lots of parameter tuning here in a convolution. This is step 3.
Afsan, a stride in step 3 can be different from stride in step 1, right?
Yeah, it can be different. Yes, it can be different. So, see, step 1, step 2, and step 3, the values, that the hyperparameter values are independent of each other. So, here, if the stride is 1, in a step 3, the stride can be anything of your choice that you have to put. It's not compulsory that you have to put the same stride here. No.
Okay.
It's clear?
Yes, thanks.
Yeah. So again, step 1 is clear to everyone?
Yes.
The resultant matrix of step 1 is then what in step 2?
Activation function.
Activation function. Basically, you have to apply ReLU or something. This is also clear. Then the resultant matrix of step 2 is what?
Pooling.
we do step three, that is called as pooling. So how many types of poolings are there?
Three.
Max,
mean, average.
And average.
Average.
Okay, now again we get a resultant matrix. Yes. Now again you have to follow from step one. Again you have to follow from step one. So when you get a resultant matrix after this, for example, this is one step, second step, third step. Again, you get a matrix, some matrix you get. Again, you have to choose the how many filters you want. Then again, you get a resultant matrix. Then again, you have to use step two, step three, and these steps goes on. And it now the number of step is also dependent on you. So what I mean to say is after doing step one, we go to step two. We go to step three. We go to again step one, step two. And this is a continuation. Okay, this is not step one, will not work with this matrix. So every time if we see the matrix is changing, right? So step one again will work on this resultant matrix, not on this matrix. Remember this, okay? It will run on step three matrix, then this goes on depending on how many convolution you want. So basically, one, two, three, then one, two, three, and one, two, three. This is from step one, two, three is called as first convolution layer. First convolution layer. Then the next step from one, two, three is called as second convolution layer. Then the third convolution layer and so on. So how many convolution layer you want to use is up to you. Is clear to everyone?
Yes.
Any doubts, they can ask me. So this steps 1, 2, 3 keeps on repeating depending on how many convolution layer you want. So if I say I want 5 convolution layer, so what that means, can anyone tell me?
So steps 1, 2, 3 repeat
5 times repeat.
Yes, so basically it's 1, 2, 3, then again on the resultant of this matrix again 1, 2, 3, and the rules are the same. How many filters you want to decide is up to you. What is the size of the filter is up to you. Everything is up to you. So 1, 2, 3. Then we have 1, 2, 3. This is what? 1, 2, 3 is done. Then 1, 2, 3. This is done. Then we have 1, 2, 3. This is done. This is what you mean by 5 convolution layer. So till it's clear to everyone.
Whatever parameters we have set in the first convolution layer, those will be continued for the remaining ones, or those can change?
No. It's independent of each other. So it's totally on you. So suppose you are using 10 filters in the first, second, in the second convolution, you can use 2 filters. In the third, you can use 5 filters. You can fourth, you can use 10 filters again. So it's up to you.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, so yes. So now if I show you the diagram, this will make sense now. So if I stop this, if I share you my screen, and if I show you the PPT now, so this is the PPT, okay. Now this makes sense. So the first step is convolution plus ReLU, then we have pooling, then again convolution plus ReLU, we have pooling and stuff like this. Now this first part is clear to everyone? The first diagram is clear to everyone? Now this makes sense, right? Initially it was looking rubbish, now this makes sense?
Yes.
Okay, and now after this, so this you have learned now, this is called as feature learning. See, I was telling you, right, that you have to extract the feature. So this layer is called as feature extractor. Feature extractor or feature learning, you can say. And the classification part, you know. So somehow now the total architecture is feature extraction plus classification. But the question is how to add these two now? Because this, what it takes, the classification, what it takes as the input?
Features.
Okay, let. Okay. Clear the output. Okay. Now, the output of convolution layer is what? The output at the end, what you will get? You will get a matrix. Yes?
Yes.
But in the classification, it is a neuron, right? The input layer is a number of neurons. So how to add these two now? How I will send the data of this into this? Valid question? Yes or no? If you want to, if you want to merge these two, somehow this matrix should be inserted in this neuron, right? So how to do that? Okay, so we have a step called as flatten. F-L-A-T-T-E-N, flatten. So what happens is, suppose, for example, I'm taking, okay, hypothetical example. Suppose the matrix, what I'm getting here is, at the end, okay, it's 2 cross 2. So that would be 2, 3, 4, 5. So what I have to do is, the flattening means that converting this matrix into a 1D array. Converting this matrix into a 1D array. What I mean to say is, this matrix will be converted something like this. That is 2, 3, 4, 5. Suppose you have like this. Suppose the width will be there, of course, because you're adding so much. If you 10 filter, then 10 width will be there and so on. So 2, 3, 4, 5. Then the next filter will be come. Suppose this is 6, 7, 8, 9. So 6, 7, 8, 9. And this will keep on increasing. So basically, you have to flatten everything now. So basically, now this is 2, 4, 6, 9. If you flatten this, you got 2, 4, 6, 9. So how many input nodes will be there?
4.
Exactly. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this you don't have to decide. What you have to decide is what will be the nodes in hidden 1, hidden 2, hidden 3. This is exactly what you have learned in ANN. That exactly you have to follow here. There is nothing special for convolution. The same technique you have to follow here. So the input. So once you've done the flattening, the input layer will be automatically created depending on how many elements are there in the flatten. So you don't have to worry about that. You have to just worry about the hidden layers. So this is how you merge convolution with classification, and it together becomes convolution neural network. So now it's clear to everyone, the whole architecture. So if I show you diagram again, now it will, the whole diagram will make sense now. So share. And this is the whole diagram now, see. So what you do convolution plus ReLU, then you do pooling, then again, you follow the steps. Once you're satisfied with the step, then you do the flatten, see, you do the flatten here. After doing the flattening, you just do the full connecting and just do the classification, that's it. This is what a convolution neural network is. So basically, CNN typically has three layers, a convolution layer, a pooling layer, and a fully connected layer. So a convolution layer, a pooling layer, and a fully connected layer. And we have joining all three, and this becomes convolution neural network. And the calculation is very simple. It's element-wise calculation, that's it, nothing else. Again, it is a black box thing. So what feature it is extracting, you will not know. So the job of this convolution is to give the feature, and based on this feature, the job of CNN is to classify that whether it's card, cat, or dog. And can anyone tell me what this is? The forward propagation. What will happen in backward propagation? Which all weights will increase or decrease? So this hidden layer weights will increase as the weights what we have. It will increase and decrease, of course, this you know. But in convolution, which weight will change itself?
Filters.
The filter weights, exactly. The filter weights will keep on increasing or decreasing based on the accuracy or the loss function. And the loss function is also the same, what we have. So this is how training works behind the scene. So now convolution is clear to everyone?
Yes.
Any doubts in convolution? Now this diagram makes sense to everyone. Initially, when you saw it will be looking tough, right? Now it makes sense. Then this is the concept of convolution neural network. Yes, and if yes, go ahead.
Softmax is again a
activation function on the output layer, right?
Softmax is the one of the again activation function. Yes. So okay. I will. Yeah. So softmax is the activation function. Just the formula is different. That's it. Nothing else. Yeah. So this is, if you know, so in the interview, when someone asks you, they will ask you the same thing. Okay. So they will tell you, please show me the step one of convolution. Please explain me the step one of convolution neural network. So you have to basically take one figure. You have to take figure in the sense that what I explained to you, 5 cross 5. take a filter of one and explain what happens behind the scene. That's it. This is only what they will ask in interview. Then they will ask what do you mean by pooling. So just tell that if you want to decrease the matrix size, so to decrease the matrix size, we use pooling. So this is what an interview question they ask. They will not ask that what are the features that are extracted, what are this, what is extracted. No, they will not ask this thing. They will ask that how to decide filter value, how to decide this value, how to decide that value. That is dependent on you. Okay, so again, here also we have a tip, a trick that we have in neural network. So what are the tricks that I have told you in neural network? ANN?
Hidden layer should be lesser than the previous one.
Exactly. So basically, if you're using 24, so the next hidden layer, it will be less than 24, right?
Yes.
Okay. So in this, the simple trick is, so let me again go to, okay, you can say the best practice, okay, not a trick, a best practice to build a neural network. Filter size, sorry, the filters, filter numbers on every convolution will increase. Suppose if the filter I am choosing here is 10, then the next convolution step, it should be more than 10. So it should be 20. And in the next, it will be more than 20. So it can be 21, 22, 23, but it should be more than 20. Okay. So again, I follow the same rule. In that, I do divide by 2. In this, I do multiply by 2. So this is my way of doing. Okay. Suppose in the first, I am taking filter of 10. In the next, my filter will be 20. In the next convolution, my filter will be 40. Like this, I go. So this is one step I follow, and this is the best practice that you have to keep on increasing the size of, not the size of the filter, sorry, number of filters. Sorry, my bad. Number of filters in each of the convolution layers. This is clear?
Yes.
Okay, yes. And the second best practice is the max pooling size will always be 2x2 with the stride 2. The matrix will be 2x2 with stride 2. This is the best practice. So you don't have to work with this. So by default, you take the matrix of 2x2 and a stride 2, that's it. So basically, what I'm doing is I'm doing input image. If I have 6x6, if I do max pooling of 2x2 with stride 2, what will be the output matrix? 3x3, because I'm doing divide by 2, that's it. So it will be 3x3. Getting my point? Here, everyone? Yes or no?
Yes.
So basically, the stride will be 2x2 by default, so you don't have to change the stride. This is the, so you can practice, of course, you can change. It's totally hyperparameter to anything, but one of the best practices is go with the default. You never change the pool size or the pool size. Okay, so it should be 2x2 with stride 2 always. And for the convolution, for the classification, you know the rules, you have to follow the same rules. But here the filter size will keep on increasing. In there, the hidden size, the number of neurons keep on decreasing. This is the only difference between the two. That's it. So these are the only two practice I know. And yeah, and one more is, we always use ReLU. We never use softmax in convolution neural network. We always go with ReLU. We never use softmax. Oh, sorry, not softmax, sigmoid function. So the first is, number of filters, what should happen? It should increase or decrease after each convolution?
Increase.
In step two, which activation function you have to use always?
ReLU.
What should be the max pool size? Or the pool size?
2x2 and stride 2.
And stride 2. And once you have to just keep on repeating, and the flatten. We don't have any rule in flatten because you have to just flatten, so no rules. So flatten, and then you have classification, and these rules you already know. That's what you have to do. So when you attach these two with the help of coding, then you are building a convolution neural network layer. Then you are building a CNN layer. So we will try to see the coding of this in tomorrow's class. So anyone has a doubt in this, and I've asked in the starting class also, have you practiced some of the dataset in ANN also or not?
Not yet.
No. Okay, just try to practice, okay? Because if you are going into this field, is very interesting, okay? So I have showed you my example also, right? The mask one and stuff like that. This field is very interesting to work with. This is not machine learning that you will be boring and know. It is very interesting. So if you're interested, try to practice. Okay. If once you start practicing, you know, then you will not stop. Believe me. You will just then search for another data set. So I understand that ANN is not of your interest, because who will do that prediction thing with ANN? We have machine learning for that. But convolution neural network, please try to practice this with the images. Okay. So I will try to give the data set. So at the end of the day, so I have tomorrow's time and I have next Saturday's time. Okay, I have just 2 days left. So what I will do is tomorrow I will just show you the hands-on on basic data set that we have. So basically what I will do is there's something called as MNIST data set. And there is something called as FMNIST data set, and this is a CIFAR data set. This I will show you tomorrow. All three I will show you tomorrow. And on Saturday, we will do some big project. Big project in the sense, some sensible project like cat and dog classification. So we will train this and we will see that if we are putting the image of cat, whether my network is saying whether it's cat or not. So this is the use case that we'll do on next Saturday, but tomorrow I will show you the small use cases. Okay, so let me introduce to the data set that I will use, that I will show you tomorrow. So but it would be incomplete when it reaches the end. But why we are using more filters here? So Shubhangi, your question is clear. Why we are using more filters? To get more features.
Yes, Afsan.
Yeah, okay. So Arijit. Yeah, so but it would be still be incomplete. Arijit, can you explain this? What do you mean by this?
So Afsan, it was like during that padding that you were talking about.
Mm-hmm.
So there you mentioned, right? If it's a 7x7 matrix and we use a 2x2 and then we take a stride of 2, we were ending up with one extra column.
Ah, okay. Now it's clear.
Like, when we have to tune the parameter. Yeah, that's
clear. This is clear, right? And
yeah.
Gaurav has said 2. Okay, step. Okay, so something. Let me open. Okay, so we'll work with MNIST dataset. So I will show you what is MNIST dataset I'll be working on. So MNIST data set. Okay, so this is the MNIST dataset. So basically, MNIST dataset is nothing but it is a number. Okay, it is an image of a digits from 0 to 9. So if you train the dataset, my model will be able to tell that it whether the image of is of 0. Of 1, of 2, of 3, of 4, of 5, and stuff like that. Okay. So if I show you MNIST images, this is a data set. So this is a data set that will be given to you, and you have to train on in this data set. You have to train the data set. And at the end, what my CNN will do is, so whenever he will show the image of 1 to him, the CNN will automatically detect that this is the image of 1. The image of 2, image of 3, and stuff like this. Okay, this is MNIST data set that we have. So basically, it is a handwritten data set from 0 to 9. Then we have FMNIST. F stands for fashion. Okay, so FMNIST is a fashion. Now we will train our data on this data set what we have. So we will train our data set on this. That is sneakers, shirt, bag, sneakers, ankle boot, shirt, and this. And whenever you show him the shoes or goggles or some stuff like that, it will try to identify whether that thing is a sneaker or a shirt or a t-shirt and stuff like this. So two use cases and an interesting one, yes? Use case and interesting, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Then we have CIFAR 10. CIFAR 10, what we have is we have an image of this. So we have an image of aeroplane, we have an image of car, we have an image of birds, we have an image of animals. So basically, we will train shapes and stuff like that. So CIFAR 10, I will tell you the what we have. Okay, so CIFAR 10. So when I click on this, so these are the images. See, we have the aeroplane images, we have automobile. CIFAR 10 means number of classification that we have. So here we have 10 classification and these are the classification. So aeroplane, automobile, bird, cat, deer, dog, frog, horse, and ship and truck. We will try to train this data set. And at the end of the day, my model will be able to predict whether that particular image is of a ship, of an aeroplane, of a car, and stuff like that. So these three we will see tomorrow. And this is the data set. And don't worry about data set. Don't just hunt about data set. I will give you all the steps, how to download data set, how to use data set, everything. Okay. And we have CIFAR 100 also. CIFAR 100 means 100 classification. Okay. Now this is the advanced version of CIFAR 10. So here it will be chair, couch, table, wardrobe. So there will be 100 classes. That's it. So train, truck, then palm, pine, willow, lizard, snake, spider, and stuff like this. This is CIFAR 10. And what I will do is I will teach you cat and dog as a main use case. So basically you have to, okay, I will cat and dog CNN. If you go to images, so basically I will teach you this as a main use case. Okay, so I hope with all the use cases, I think you will be able to do any kind of use case on your own. So take a image, take a data set from online. So you have Kaggle to take the data set, just train on the data set. That's it. So basically what you can do is, we have flower data set CNN. So lots and lots of data set we have. See, flower recognition, then we have fruit recognition. Just try to practice on all this data set and then try to deploy it on the Samara software, something like that. That's it. This is what you have to do. So this is clear to everyone?
Yes.
So I hope this class will be more interesting tomorrow when we will train the data set.
Yes.
Yeah. So
Afsan, okay. Hello.
Yes. Go ahead.
So you have created that wearing the you have wear the mask or not by the FMNIST, right?
Yes.
So that FMNIST is used for the costumes actually.
Yes.
But when it is come to the MNIST, that is just for the numerical
yes.
things.
Yes.
And other one is
CIFAR 10.
CIFAR 10 is find the object-wise thing.
Yes. Exactly. So for the mask one, if you're asking the mask one, no. So which I've showed you have to take the data set of a mask. So you have to click a photo where people is wearing mask, and you have to click the photo where you have to, people is not wearing a mask, and you have to train on that. So you have to clear the data set there. Yeah.
Okay.
So yes. So if I show you, suppose let me show you my GitHub, if GitHub is there or not. Let's see. GitHub of Sun. Then repositories. Face mask. Okay, face mask detector. I have the code. So let's see if the data set is there. Okay. Mask detection. Let's see from where I've taken data set. Okay, it's a use file, so it will not load, I think. So let me check. Okay, it's not loading. So I will show the data set here only. Okay, so face mask data set. Face mask set Kaggle. I will go to Kaggle directly. Kaggle is the best place to search for face mask detection. And see, download. So this is the image that you have to select. Person with and without mask to train a data.
It's a very huge amount of data.
39. Yeah. Actually, so see, if you want to get a good accuracy, as I told you in the earlier class, you need a large amount of data. Remember in the first PPT.
Yeah.
So yes.
Yeah.
So that you have to do. You can't. So if you see the FMNIST also, there are 60,000 data. If you yes. noticed.
Yeah. If you go there.
So. MNIST data set, and if I show you this handwritten data set, see training a label, see the size. Okay, once you see the size, see
210, I think.
So basically the size is small, that's why it's something like this. See, it contains 60,000 digit images. So size is very large. Okay, so yes. Same for CIFAR also. If I go to CIFAR 10, okay, it's not CIFAR, it's CIFAR. CIFAR 1000, see, it is 60,000 images. And 6,000 is for testing. Oh, sorry, 50,000 is for testing. See,
50,000 is for testing, and per class, sorry, it is having
it is total of 60,000, where 50,000 is for training and 10,000 for testing. So yes, the number of and see the size 163 MB. So see, if you are building a data, then you have to have very large amount of data to train on that. So yes, so if you have a large data, then your accuracy will be good, and you can build any model on that. So this is a face mark direction I have told you. So actually, all the projects what I have shown you is present on my GitHub. So if you are interested, you can just download this and use that. And I have the model also saved. If you want to use the model, you can directly use the model. This is the Pi version of that. So you can just run this. Okay, so yes, this is what CNN is. So actually, I also got accuracy of 98%. So basically, okay, this is not an image. Okay. Library, yeah, this is the image that we are taking with mass and without mass. This is how you calculate, this is how you collect, do the collection of the images. And on this data, you have to train your data. So, this is what I have done behind the scene in face mark detection. So, this is clear to everyone. The future classes, the two classes we are remaining, that now the two classes will be fully on practical session. So that you will get a very good hands-on on all the CNN and everything.
So the deployment of deep learning models are similar to the normal machine learning model, right?
Yes, yes, it is totally similar. The only thing is you have to take the image from the user.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, so you have to just take the image from the user. So I will just give you the code if you want. So what you have to do is instead of passing that matrix, you have to pass the image to the model. That's it.
Okay, right.
Okay, so tomorrow's class, we'll see how to do a prediction and it will be clear. So we'll save the model and we'll try to do, we will try to send some pictures to the model through the Jupyter Notebook only, of course, but it will make it clear that how we'll do in Flask. Okay. Yeah. So yes, everyone, this is for today. I think just revise all the topics, okay? Just try to practice all the topics that I've covered today, basically. And yes, and tomorrow we will implement that thing. Okay, everyone, have a great day. Bye-bye.